Hello there, everyone. My name is Oversoul. This is Oversoul Gaming, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance HD. And now we've visited Prankster's Paradise as Sora for a little bit, and now we're going to visit as Riku for a little bit, and then we will go back to Sora, and then back to Riku, as is the usual way. 3, 2, 1, dive! Derly deerfern derby deer schneeby deerfin burp. Okay. Anywho, man, this one is a lot of ducking and weaving. Could only get one of those. Not possible to get both. Whoosh! Whoosh! Yeah! It is really hard to do this and not run into anything, trust me. Oh my goodness. You know, those Dream Eaters seem a lot like the, ouch, fuck, Ghost Heartless from the Underworld in Kingdom Hearts 2. Ah, damn it, I missed both of those. Okay, let's try this. Okay, I have never done that without running into something before, so that was pretty cool. Haha, I grabbed it without going through. Shit! Well, never mind that one. Yeah. Oh, did you see that? Those stars were shaped like a whale. That's kind of cool. Silver Diver. Pfft, fuck you. To be completely honest, I have no idea why they decide to call the world Prankster's Paradise when Riku visits. Because, I mean, Riku doesn't actually visit the world itself like Sora does. Riku's visit here takes place exclusively inside Monstro.
Isn't that Geppetto? Then this must be...
Yup. But I guess they decided, nah, Monstro's not a world, Monstro is a character. That was dumb of us in the first game. So... What? Boy, remember how difficult it was to get all of these items in Monstro's mouth in Kingdom Hearts 1? You had to have, like, high jump, first of all. Now we can just flow motion our way on top of things, and everything is perfectly cool. Oh, holy Christmas nipples. Hold on. I want to make sure I get everything. Woohoo! Before moving on with the story. Alright, we're good. Geppetto. Let's talk, brah.
What's the matter?
Huh? Goodness, who are you?
Riku.
Oh, Riku, you poor lad. Seems you were swallowed up by Monstro just like the rest of us.
Not quite.
My name is Geppetto.
You see, I'm just passing through, old man.
Pinocchio's gone missing?
I'm afraid so.
After yeah, it's quite unfortunate, really.
I found him here in the whale, but then he ran off again to who knows where.
That sounds kind of familiar.
Yeah, you mean like what happened in the first game?
Let me go look for your son.
You would do that? Thank you. Are you sure?
Sure, it's not like I have anything better to do.
Yeah, leave it to me.
This is probably a sleeping world, so there's probably a keyhole, so you know I gotta do the thing anyways.
Jiminy?
Huh? That's right. Name's Jiminy. Jiminy Cricket.
Again with this shit? Come on.
Have we met?
No. You know, never mind.
At least Riku was quicker to accept it. Sora had to sit there and think about it like, huh, wait a minute, this doesn't make sense. Oh, that's right, it was explained to me previously. I bumped my head one too many times.
Can you describe
Sora's starting to turn into Goofy. You know you're pretty bad when Goofy's fucking smarter than you.
A black coat.
A black coat? He's back again.
Oh, nice. Young Xehanort, is there any world in which you will not cause a ruckus?
Well, I'm going with you. Pinocchio's gonna need his conscience. And
Pinocchio's... What Pinocchio needs is a good ass-whooping. Sit your ass down and shut the hell up, boy. You wanna be real so goddamn bad, you best listen! Stop misbehaving.
Take this!
No, I don't know.
Take this!
Would it really make a difference? He's a puppet. It's not like he can actually, like, feel anything physically, so you could spank him and it would just be like, okay, whatever. Would hurt you more than it would him. You're spanking, like, a block of wood. Like, ow. Get into Booble. Yeah, that's right, bitch. Get in there. Boo-hoo! Come on. Enemies that hide underground in any video game? Such a cheap move. And where the fuck were you, useless bastards, this whole time, huh? Just having a merry old sing-along over here? Happy Valentine's Day, by the way, to everybody, I guess. I don't know. Fuck. You may have, someone, and you may not. Either way, happy day of the Valentino to you. If you don't have a Valentine, I will be your Valentine today. Yes. Come sit next to Oversoul. Get comfortable. For you see, today, I am going to be your Valentine, and we're going on a date together inside the guts of a whale. Look at it, it's nice and pretty. Look, it's got all of the Valentine colors, pink and purple and red and intestines, you know? All good stuff. All very good stuff. So, yeah, I could be your Valentino, for realino. As we travel through Monsterino. Yes, good. Mm-hmm. I just checked those to see if they can give me Dream Eaters to help me fight. You know, ones that will actually fight and not just sit there and look stupid. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Bam!
Yeah.
The internal layout of Monstro here in Dream Drop Distance is probably slightly different than you remember. Outside of the mouth, it is actually completely different. Damn, what does it take to kill you fucks? Obviously a little bit more of that. Nope, never mind. Going this way. Screw off, bitches. Wait, is there a treasure chest down there? Can't tell. There is not. Nothing down here but a waste of time. Alright, got it. Oh wait, there is! There it is! It was hiding behind the springy thingy. You little sneak. Okay, we got it now. There appears to be more over this invay. Something over here? Ah, yes.
Yeah.
A magic spell that I will never use. That was completely worth going out of my way for. Why the hell not, right? Oh, good. More cutscene.
Pinocchio!
Jiminy!
Let him go now!
He said, okay, here you go. And just pushes him. I don't want this damn thing anyways.
Thank goodness. Are you all right? Riku and I looked for you everywhere.
Uh-huh. I'm just fine. Sorry, Jiminy. I messed up real bad. You and Father must have been so worried about me.
Why, Pinocchio? I think you just might be finally starting to learn.
Don't let him get off the hook easy, though. Punish his ass.
Who are you?
This is why children never learn. Oh, shit.
Me?
Well, of course, because that's what happened in Monstro in the first game. Riku kidnapped Pinocchio.
And I live and breathe.
That was my dark side.
There you go.
I gave in to the darkness once.
At least Riku understands what's going on.
It's chased me around in one form or another. The seeker of darkness who stole my body. A puppet replica of the shadows in my heart. And now, I'm facing me.
Your dark side?
Gee, Riku, don't you have a Jiminy like I do? He's my conscience. He's taught me all.
Well, I mean, if you want to be technical, Mickey is kind of Riku's Jiminy.
Sure. You can't shoulder all your problems alone, you know. You must have somebody. A friend you can talk to?
Yeah. Actually, I do.
And he realizes that now.
He's always wearing. He's the best teacher I could ever have.
Gee whiz! I wish I had lots of good friends.
You will, Pinocchio. More than you can count.
Don't give that boy false hope. That's not the case for most people.
What now? Is something in there?
I'll tell you
Pinocchio,
what happens,
Jiminy,
Pinocchio. What
back.
Happens is you start making friends, okay?
Okay.
Probably somewhere around your late teens into your early 20s, and you make a shitload of friends, right? Well, that's when you're at that stage where you want to party and stuff all the time, you know? People are always asking you to go out, and you're like, yeah, let's go out, let's have some drinks, let's go to my buddy's house, trash the place, get drunk all weekend, blah, 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 you know? And that's all fun and well for that point in time, but eventually it gets to a point where it's like, okay, this is getting old, this is getting worn out, I'm getting tired of this shit. And you slowly start to mature, and you realize that a lot of these friends that you had were really just drinking buddies or partying buddies, people that you really couldn't stand spending time with when you're not intoxicated. Or like, some people that were your friends, maybe. You know, anything can happen, even if someone was your friend. There's a good chance, Pinocchio, that they might betray you eventually. And so, it stands to reason that as you get older, you start losing friends that you made when you were younger because you start to mature and realize who is and isn't really your friend. And this isn't, I'm not trying to be pessimistic, this is just a fact of life. Very rarely will you grow up and have all of the same friends that you made in high school. Or when you're in your 40s, there's a high chance that you won't have all the same friends that you had in your 20s. Now, that's not the case for everybody. Some people are just there for life, you know? But, you know, I think a lot of people, like, you know, this is why the whole concept of Facebook friends is kind of stupid, because not everyone who is, I guarantee you, not everyone on your Facebook friends list is an actual friend. Some of them are probably just associates, you know, and such like that. But, I mean, I get why they call it friends list, but you know what I mean. Anyways. You know, some of them are just people with mutual interests, like, Ryan Bodash. If you've seen some of my other videos, you know him. He got a bunch of friend requests recently, and a lot of people just went to add him because they liked his hair. So, you know, it's just stuff like that, you know, it gets you thinking, and you're like, okay, well, eventually you get to a point in your life where... What the hell is going on here? Okay, I need to get out of the stomach bile. Anyways, eventually you get to a point in your life where you grow up and you mature, and you don't want to have people over all the time, you don't want to party all the time anymore, you know, you want to, like, settle down and focus on your future, you know, try to start a career, maybe, you know, shit like that. And, when that happens, you will slowly start to realize who was and wasn't your friend, all along, because there are certain people that were in it a lot of the time to party with you and such. And of course, I'm speaking from personal experience here, but I'm not the only person in the world who's had this experience. That's just a fact. I know that. So, you know, there were people that just, that were there just to party with you. You know, that's all they wanted. They just wanted to party. They just wanted to kick it. You know, that was their main goal. Okay. And then you have, the people who, and when they see that you're trying to change your life for the better, and, or like, you know, just move on, and, you know, mature, and focus on important things, you can tell who is and, you can tell who in, is and isn't in your corner, and, who was and wasn't a friend based on the people who support your choices, like, you know, based on the people who support you trying to do what's right in your life, you know? Like, for example, I guess I probably should have put this into word-like examples, it would have made more sense, but like... Ah, shit, these damn Hengerwins. You know, we might actually finish all of Riku's visit here, in this episode, because it's not very long, so... Riku's visit here to this world is relatively short, considering the whole thing takes place inside of a whale. So, also, this time Riku and Sora don't fight the same Dream Eater boss. However, it is practically the same. It's basically two different versions of the same monster. It's just that one is fire and one is ice, but otherwise it's the fucking same. So... Oh shit, I did that a little early. I don't think I meant to do it that soon. But anyways, let me give you an example of what I'm talking about so it doesn't just sound like I'm just rambling about personal experiences. Like, for example, and we've all known someone who does this, but... I have a friend who used to always just, like, beg me to come over every weekend and party. Be like, he would text me and my other friends would be like, "Hey ladies, you bitches gonna come to my place and get wrecked this weekend?" And I'd be like, "I can't, man, this weekend. I got shit to do, you know, my fiance wants to hang out and do stuff. You know, I've got stuff I want to work on. You know, things like that." And he'd be like, "Man, stop being such a little pussy and just come join me," you know, shit like that. Like, those people aren't forever, you know? Because it's obvious that their mind is only on one thing, and they only care about that particular thing. I'm actually still friends with this person, believe it or not. We do not talk much anymore, and we haven't hung out in forever. Because it's just... At the end of the day, he doesn't do that shit anymore, and that's why. If he still did that shit, I wouldn't talk to him anymore, because I'm beyond that crap now. But he did used to, and it was really annoying. Wait, this is a treasure? No, okay. Alright, not sure what I just... Oh, I get it. Oh wow, I actually did not do that before. To get up here? I've never done that before. I always just flow motioned my way up there. Huh. Interesting.
Take this. Ha!
But anyways, I'm not trying to say, hey, you shouldn't make friends and... No, make friends. Like, you know, don't go through school without friends and shit like that, you know? It would be difficult, but don't expect all of the friends that you make to always be there for you. It's just that it's just the way of life. Things, they change. Okay? Yeah. Nothing is forever. Things change. You will probably make you will definitely make some friends in your life that will be there forever, but I can promise you that not every friend that you come across is someone who's going to be there forever. Here's a few examples of reasons that I have lost friends. And, you know, let me know in the comments below if you can relate to any similar situations. I had one friend who I knew from college, who we ended up, like, I knew him from college, but we didn't really hang out or anything, but then ended up having jury duty together one day much later after we both finished that particular class. And so after that jury duty, we ended up hanging out. And so we ended up hanging out, and we ended up hanging out a lot. Yeah. And we had a lot of similar interests. We had a lot of fun hanging out for that exact reason. It was pretty cool. But then, and he liked all of my friends. My friends liked him. It was really cool. But then one day, he just up and disappeared. Just completely vanished. And that was the end of it. And we never knew what happened to him. He just vanished. One friend that I had, we found out that he was cheating on another one of my friends who, basically, there were a lot of people that were in on-again, off-again relationships within my friend circle, which is another reason that I just cannot, I don't know, it's another reason I'm glad that I don't hang out with as many people anymore, because a lot of my friend group had this problem with high school drama very bad. And it just got really annoying and emotionally draining, and it's just like, come on, this is beneath me now. Like, and no offense to any of you who are currently in high school or anything, if you have high school drama, good. Be glad for the fact that that's the only problem you have right now. Because when you become an adult and you end up getting your own place and shit like that, you end up having adult problems, like bills. So, I would... But the thing is, when you're an adult, high school problems are annoying. Because it's just like... You know, you do think there's this whole thing where it's like, man, I would just love to go back to being a kid and whatnot. In some aspects, yes. But in other aspects, definitely not. Because... There's a point where you have to just move beyond some of that stuff and mature yourself. And I'm not saying you're ever going to be too old for things like Pokemon or anything like that. Fuck no. But, I mean, look at me. I'm playing Kingdom Hearts. But what I am saying is that you're never too old for certain tastes, but you do become too old for certain behaviors. And certain behaviors are just... Ugh. So anyways, back to what I was saying. So I had a friend who cheated on another friend, so that's why we don't talk to him anymore, because I don't condone that kind of crap. And, Boonga! I definitely, I don't I can't even words correctly right now. No, I don't, definitely don't condone that nonsense. I'm trying to think some more examples. I've already told the story in my Birth by Sleep playthrough about two of my friends who betrayed me, but there was the one who, pretended to be supportive of me, but ended up just turning out to be a liar, and then there was the one who, also, through lying, managed to cause severe emotional and financial damage to me and my fiancé and my fiancé's parents. Anyways, there's... Basically, out of everybody I know, this person used to be in my videos a lot because we used to be really close, which is why this particular betrayal stings so much. But this particular person... There is absolutely no hope in hell of him coming back from what he did. It was that bad. So, Yeah, it just goes to show. But this is also the kind of person who I should have seen the red flags before, and I was just unwilling to see them because we were so close. Like, he was a good friend, don't get me wrong, but he had a problem with making really stupid decisions without thinking about it that would oftentimes cause problems for other people. And one of those stupid decisions was just the last straw. And, but before that, we were good friends. We used to hang out all the time. We had a lot of similar interests and stuff. But, you know, eventually it comes to a point where you realize that similar interests and having fun hanging out is just not enough. He was a good friend, though. You know, I still have some memories of him on YouTube and through stuff that he's given me that I still have and still use. They were gifts. Of course I'm still going to use them. Just because he turned into an asshole doesn't mean I won't remember the good times and enjoy them as such. But anywho, I know you come to these videos expecting me to do Kingdom Hearts, like, explanations of this shit, but these past couple of episodes that we've been doing don't require many explanations. You know, either the characters themselves have explained things, or it's just self-explanatory to begin with. So, got him. Gotta love that strike raid. But anyways, yeah, so I've had a lot of people come in and out of my life for a multitude of different reasons. I've had friends, Facebook friends that I've never met in real life, delete me just because they don't, they didn't agree with my opinion on something, so, you know, screw it. That kind of stuff doesn't matter as much as, like, the other real life betrayals and shit, but, eventually, I mean, it hurts, but eventually you move on.
On the Destiny Islands.
And you realize that your life is better without them. Like,
time was rewound in this world too.
Okay, Riku, you're smarter than that.
Sid said, the world was freed from darkness, but is
what do you mean?
Wake from it.
What do you mean? Maybe it's like Master Yen Sid said. No, it's exactly like Master Yen Sid said. Don't be fucking stupid, Riku. I know you're smarter than that. I mean, do we really need to explain it again? I sure as hell hope we don't have to. It's pretty damn obvious. Aside from the grid, every world that they've visited so far is a world that is stuck in a time loop because it hasn't fully awakened from the darkness yet. And Sora and Riku are awakening these worlds, restoring them back to their full selves yet again. And these time loops that they stuck in are some of the final events before they went, or before the world was destroyed by Heartless. Matter of fact, when in the next episode, when we deal with Sora's final part of this world, we will actually dive into that concept a little bit. So, anyways, but that'll be it for this episode, so thank you all so much for watching. My name is Oversoul, this is Oversoul Gaming, you've been fantastic, and I will catch you, possibly on another day, definitely at another time, and likely in another video. Okay, goodbye!